Here at Ballyhack, for the past 4 years, we have conducted 4 different research studies to look at selective Bermudagrass control in creeping bentgrass fairways. One of these studies actually is on its 3rd year of data collection with 2 years of treatment. So the treatment programs we have here at Ballyhack center around Pilex at 1/4 ounce per acre. And that's a low rate when you consider that in other areas of the country in Bermudagrass, Pilex is actually labeled at 3/4 ounce per acre for goose grass control. And so how do you control Bermudagrass at such low rates in bentgrass fairways? So that would be using other herbicides, using mechanical destruction or damage to Bermudagrass, and also centering your programs at sensitive time, or when Bermudagrass is sensitive in the year, such as fall or late fall or early spring. The treatment programs for this initial studies include Pilex applied at 0.25 fluid ounces per acre, plus Turflon ester ultra at 0.75 fluid ounces per acre, which the Turflon ester is used primarily to decrease bleaching injury on bentgrass. Progress applied alone at 0.5 gallon per acre, and Pilex at 0.25 fluid ounces per acre, plus Turflon ester at 0.75 fluid ounces per acre, plus Progress at 0.5 gallon per acre, or 3-way of all the actives for Bermudagrass control. All 3 herbicide programs were applied 3 times in the fall, with or without mechanical slicing. What do I mean when I say mechanical slicing? Well, we have fabricated our own mechanical slicing apparatus that consists of 4 thin smooth coulters placed on 2-inch centers. And it has relatively no surface disruption when you compare it to a verticutter, which is the main reason why we moved away from the verticutter, as it could cause unacceptable damage on the bentgrass after so many consecutive uses with short reapplication intervals.
And these are the treatments in those first few trials only evolved around fall applications and only 1 year of application. So in the first couple studies we had in the first 2 years, we realized that the herbicides and herbicides plus slicing did have good control of Bermudagrass in season. Pilex triclopyr would be our top performer, and it's not because it had the best overall Bermudagrass control. The Pilex plus Turflon plus Progress actually had a numerical, sometimes statistical, better control of Bermudagrass, but the problem is that it was more injurious. We sometimes had turf loss and unacceptable injury versus Pilex triclopyr, or Pilex Turflon was much safer compared to the other program. And that's the program we went forward with in our new studies. And slicing did add more control to the herbicides, but when we went into the next spring and summer, we had rapid recovery, really not, that didn't allow the herbicides, the overall control of herbicides or treatments to separate. So that made us realize that we were going to have to be more aggressive and potentially have more than 1 year of treatment to have long-term control or effect on Bermudagrass. In the next 2 studies, we made 3 changes to increase Bermudagrass control compared to the first studies. That was both increasing plot size to reduce Bermudagrass encroachment to have less variability in overall in our treatments. Second was to add 3 spring herbicide-only treatments to reduce the chance or the potential for Bermudagrass recovery going into the summer, and then add a 2nd year of treatments to actually see if the addition of spring treatments would actually capitalize on a compounding or additive effect going into the 3rd year of actual long-term control. And right now we're completing one of those studies as it's in its 3rd year of data collection. We'll make 1 final rating on that trial. The 2nd study is in its 2nd round of herbicide treatments, and next year will be its final rating to determine to complete that study and to figure out exactly what we're seeing. Right now I can tell you that we are seeing in the going into the fall of the first study of our new round of experiments that we're ranging 70% to 80% control or reduction in Bermudagrass compared to the non-treated check. And to give you kind of a number, some number percent cover population, right now in a lot of the non-treated checks, we're looking at 70% to 80% Bermudagrass cover. And in the treated plots, we're looking at somewhere in the 15% to 25% range, depending on plot and population variability. It's acceptable, but when it comes to long-term eradication, we're really not sure where that is, because at 2 years of treatment, we're not getting eradication. And can we get eradication as a question for future studies to look at potentially 3 to 5 years if it can be done.